Hey guys, I'm Sariga. This is our software security project. My team members are Monica and Shakti Priya. Our topic is image encryption and decryption using Blowfish algorithm. We have used three algorithms here. One is Blowfish algorithm, another one is AES, and another one is DES. I have used Blowfish algorithm. My team member Monica have used AES algorithm, and my another teammate Shakti Priya have used DES algorithm. First, I'm going to explain you about Blowfish algorithm. Before that, we will see what is encryption. Encryption is nothing but converting information or a data into a code, especially to prevent unauthorized access. Decryption. It is a process of converting encrypted data in a form that is readable and understood by a human or a computer. Images are mostly misused by so many people. They are accessing. So we will see how it's encrypting and decrypting. Before showing code, I will show you the image. This is the image which I'm gonna take. I named it as water. Before encryption, we have only one. This is my code. I have used Java programming. First I have created a package com.java.blowfish. I have used package name as blowfish, and I have imported some files like file input stream, file not found exception, file output stream, iowa exception, input stream, output stream, invalid key exception, no such algorithm exception, bad padding exception so far, illegal block size exception, key generated, no such padding exception, secret key. I have used this many so that if any file I need to upload, like a file format, it will be useful, like a file input stream, output stream, and all. If any exception occurs, like input output exception, for that purpose I have used that exception handlings. Key generator is for reuse purpose, so that we can use this code for reuse. And cipher is nothing but it provides functionality for encryption and decryption. It also forms the core of the Java cryptographic extension framework, that means JCE framework. In this program, I first package, then imported, then I have created a class encryption file. Inside that class, I have created a constructor. Inside that constructor, I have given a try catch exception, so that if any errors occurs, it will give that name, like errors will not become what errors without knowing. If anything we have a doubtful, we can give it an exception handle inside the try catch, so that the errors won't come. Here I have given catch no such padding exception, that is the name of the exception, and I have created ex is nothing but the object of that exception. And then I have created a main class. Inside that main class, I have given input as water image, and that. And then I have defined the string encrypted file name encrypted.file.jpg and decrypted file.jpg, and its location. Location is where that water image has been stored, and I have created object for my class encrypt file equal to new encryption file. In system.out.println, I have given four statements each. First statement is starting encryption, next one is encryption completed, starting decryption, completed. When encryption started, it will be showing like starting encryption. When it completes, it will show encryption complete. After completing encryption, when decryption starts, it will show like starting decryption. When it completes, decryption completed. Then I have created a method using a name encryptor. Inside that method, inside that within that method I have passed two locations. One is the file which file that means the place where I have stored that water image, and the encrypted file which it should be stored there. It will be stored next to next so that it will be easy for us how it encrypted and how it will it is decrypted like that. This is one method. I have used length I have used length. Length is for the image, it will the encrypted file also will come for same length. Encrypted file and decrypted files will be in the same same length like original version. This is another method for decryption. Here I have placed a position for two. First path for encrypted file and next one for decryption file. Both will be in same place. That means original encrypted file, decrypted file will be in same position next to next, so that we can refer easily how it converted. First, the original image will be converted into will be encrypted. That encrypted file will be decrypted to original form. It will be similar. Now I'm going to run my program. This is my output which I written in a system.out.println. When encryption started, it was showing like this. When it ends, it will give a message like encryption completed. Once it complete, when we start decryption, it will show like starting decryption, then decryption completed. Now we will see that image. Before running the program, we had only one. After that, we had two. I have named that file encrypted file like encrypted file, decrypted file like decrypted file. Both are decrypted file and water files look same, exactly like original, both similar. And encrypted file is not same, because it cannot be accessed by any others. Before encryption, the normal image is visible. It can be accessed by any user through mail or any other social apps. After encryption, the image is converted into encrypted form and the decrypted form. The decryption is looking so similar to original, but encrypted file cannot be accessed by any other applications. Next, we will see about BES algorithm, which is done by Shakti Priya. Sorry, not DES, AES. We will see AES. AES is done by my team member Monica. She also has been used Java programming. She also use Java program. First, we will see what is AES. AES is expanded as advanced encryption standard. It is a systematic key algorithm used to encrypt the premium content from unauthorized users. It uses the same key for encryption and decryption process. Okay, now I will be explaining you the code. Here also have used the same packages for her convenience. We have created she has imported files. She have imported like a buffered image. She is using Spring applets and all, so that she used like a template. We can able to browse. Image, and then we can able to give the we can able to set the path where it should be stored, where it have to be stored, and then and then we can able to give our timing for in we can give timing for encryption and decryption. It should be in millisecond. We have taken it like milliseconds so that it will be stored easily. I'm gonna run this program. Let's see. This is her output. We have created she has created a window and she gave a button and a text and a radio button, and then encryption decryption she given a same button and then label, then button, radio button and encryption and decryption time. Here we can able to browse our files, or we can use any preserve image header, and then we can choose a directory where it should be stored, like in Java only, in Java position like package or so stores where we have to store it will be we can able to choose a directory. Once we choose it, then we can able to give a time, encryption time and decryption time. They can be begin AES. Now I'm going to browse the same file. I have stored in pictures. So I'm clicking pictures. There is water image. Then I'm choosing directory src. Then open. Now I'm giving time like 4 milliseconds. Here also 4 milliseconds. Now I begin AES. This is how it will encrypt and decrypt file, similar to Blobfish, like similar to my algorithm which I have encrypted and decrypted form. Now we will see last one. Now we are going to see about DES algorithm. DES algorithm was done by my teammate Shakti Priya. DES is expanded hash data encryption standard algorithm. It is a symmetric key algorithm for encrypting data. For encrypting data like message, text and so on. She also has used Java programming. We have used the same package here. And she has used Swing Security, Secure Random Cipher Key Generator, Secret Key Space, and Random. We have created a class DES. Inside that, she defined input message, encrypted data, decrypted message. Inside that class, she has created a constructor. Inside that constructor, she has created a try catch exception handling so that any exceptions can be handled. Input message equal to J option pan dot show input dialog bracket null, enter message to encrypt. This line will give us a dialog box and it will ask us to type a message. We can able to click OK or cancel whether we are typed correctly, or if we typed wrongly we can able to cancel, and we can it will show us the same dialog box. So if you are giving a name or a string word like anything ed, hi, hello, if we click on OK, it will encrypt that word and it will give it in form, and it will give a form in boxes, and then once that encrypted over, that encrypted file will be converted into decrypted file. It will be similar to our input, and then in output it will print that message in decrypted form, then it will show encrypted form, and then my original form will become decrypt. First my original form will be in box, so that it will be productive, and then it will be encrypted. It will show encrypted, and then encrypted will be a decrypted form. I will explain you. I will run the program so that it will be easy for us. This is the dialog box in this, and it is asking us to type a message. I'm gonna type hi in small letter. I'm going to click OK, and my string has been converted into encrypted data. It's not showing the letters which I type, but instead of that it's showing like B boxes and percentages. Now I'm going to click OK. Then my decrypted data, hi. Okay, this is a dialog box. In output here, DES symmetric key equal to, it is showing like a slash T in symmetric key format. Then my encrypted message, and then my decrypted message. This is a project, and we have thank you for listening.